This past summer in Sarasota County, we experienced record-breaking temperatures for one of the hottest summers yet to date. While some relied on their AC units to keep them from overheating, here in the district, we depended on chiller plants to keep us cool.
So a chiller is what we would call an electromechanical piece of equipment. Its function in life is to produce chilled water in the area of 40 to 50 degrees Fahrenheit. It uses the mechanical compression refrigeration system to do that, just as a car air conditioner or a residential air conditioner. It's just a lot bigger and produces water. Once that water is produced, we use pumps to pump it underground in underground piping to air handling units that passes through coils with fans that move air over it and then make people comfortable in the classrooms and other areas of the schools.
If we hadn't had the chiller plants during this heat wave, it would have been far worse than what we experienced, because you got to think about the number of systems that would have been in place without chillers.
We would have hundreds, literally hundreds of individual units. We would have to have an army just to be able to handle that and the number of problems that would be associated with those types of units.
When a problem arises at a chiller plant, it's able to be assessed and taken care of all within one location. In fact, the technicians are usually able to view the issue through the building automation system before even arriving on site.
They are trained to look for things that are out of place. We have alarms that are generated by the system where they can see things that aren't running or temperatures that are too warm, things like that.
All the schools in the district have 1 to 3 chillers depending on the size of the school. And out of that number, the majority of these chillers are working in conjunction with ice plants in order to not have to operate during peak times.
Peak time is when, like, most of industry is running for manufacturing and things like that. So what this means is every night at 10 p.m., we start producing ice in these large tanks, which are about 8 feet tall, big cylindrical tanks. The ice is produced from 10 p.m. until the tanks are essentially full. It would be equivalent to like you taking like a freezer pack and putting it into your freezer and freezing it solid.
This ice is then melted during the day to provide cool air in schools, which allows us to use our systems efficiently and save money by keeping power bills down.
The HVAC department, we have one thing in mind, and that is the students. To keep them comfortable, the teachers, the staff at each school site and all of the other sites every day.